treated. What does it mean? Just tell me, what do you? It's nullified, right? So a lot of a common sort of conception is that if it's compensated, it means the pH is back to normal, right? So it is actually not that. So we'll just talk a little bit about compensation in that sort of thing. So you've heard that pH is regulated by, is held constant. And for the sake of this talk and the other talk that I'm going to give you, we're going to talk to the bicarbonate and hydrogen sort of theory. We're not going to talk about base excess or the Stewart approach, okay? So just to make things straightforward and simple, we'll talk about this one approach. So we know that the pH is held constant at about 7.4, and you've got a respiratory component, which is taken care of by the ventilation, by the lungs, and the metabolic component, which is taken care of by the kidneys. And these two processes try and regulate the pH in the range of 7.4. Okay. Now, what happens is that you can have a problem, and you can have the CO2 going up. And if the CO2 goes up, then the pH will obviously slide to the towards the acidotic range. Now, what the body does is that the body will try to neutralize the effect of this disturbance by making a change on the other side. And simply speaking, that is what compensation is. Is that if there is a primary change in one of these, the other side will move to minimize the effect on the pH. Okay. So the key concept that you need to keep in mind is that compensation is an attempt by the body to minimize the effect of the disturbance on the pH, not to neutralize or to normalize the pH. It is an attempt towards normalization, but it never actually results in absolute normalization. Okay, so let's say there was a metabolic acidosis because of diabetes, diabetic ketoacidosis, and the pH, if you just took the amount of acid that was there in the body, the pH would have been, say, 7.1. Right? Now the body will try and do something to the respiratory component, because if the metabolic component is altered, then the respiratory component will move to minimize the effect, and it will move the pH towards 7.4, but will never actually become 7.4. So you might get the pH becoming 7.25 or 7.3. So compensation is an attempt by the body to minimize the impact of the primary disturbance on the pH. Is that clear? Okay, it's not normal. So if you say, oh, pH is not 7, pH is 7.3, so it is uncompensated, that is not true. Okay, so keep this in mind first. Okay, so if one variable changes, like I said, either